The question, I guess, is...
How do you describe Fairfield High in one word?
One word, kicking.
Nuclear.
The best. Neat.
Exotic.
Fairfield High is fun.
It's fun!
Fairfield High in one word, fresh.
It's awesome.
Fantastic.
Red, white, and black?
Friendly. A melting pot.
Different.
What?
Okay, describe Fairfield High in one word.
Great.
Why?
I don't know. I can't describe it in one word.
Personally, I think it's a pretty rowdy bunch. It's a really great school.
Fairfield High is...
Well, you just have to experience it yourself.
Down on the corner, out in the street, playing a ball for the band, bringing his girls happy feet.
Thank you.
she nuts.
My buddy Stan. We do everything together.
Oh, I didn't want to come along.
Well, actually, I didn't get that.
We started organizing about mid-September. We're doing the Block F dance for, we raised money for girls' athletics.
Takes a lot of dedication and perseverance.
This is a sport you have to think a lot, and it takes a great deal of your energy.
Just think about totally demolishing the guy and then go out and wrestle.
Think positive and just try to go out there and visualize myself taking him down and beating him.
You just want to go out there and win and do the best you can.
What are some of the feelings after the match, after you just faced a tough opponent?
Well, you feel good because you know that you beat somebody who is either as good or better than you, and you just feel good that you won one for the team. And
well, it feels good when you win, but if you lose, you know, feel pretty bad. But if you know you tried your hardest to do it the next, you know, doesn't matter when it is.
Celebrated for the baby Jesus, the Christ being born, not be buying presents and things for each other.
It's time for sharing.
What is Christmas?
Everything is green and red.
And white.
Christmas vacation. Christmas is love.
Chef Ross tingling your nose.
Christmas is Christmas, man.
Showing love for your family.
That's when you spend all your paycheck on your friends and family.
Together,
togetherness.
Like
this whole Yearbook staff in one
turkey. Do ask for everything you want, and don't drink and drive.
Do join the 40 OZ club.
Don't get on your parents' bad side.
Eat a lot. Don't get too fat.
Don't spend too much money on girls.
I think the dues for Christmas should be kind to your family, and you don't. Don't burn down your Christmas tree.
Don't do drugs.
A do for Christmas is to be caring to all people
and a don't is not to be a Scrooge.
Don't go Christmas shopping at the last minute.
Don't ask for anything expensive.
Holiday time have to be festive.
Always give a present to somebody. Christmas don't is meant to be Scrooge.
Have to be nice.
Go to church.
Remember where Christmas started.
Don't be afraid to make Christmas cards, you know?
Yes.
It's really sweet.
Christmas
like
cards
that.
Really capture the moment.
You know, be nice to your mother.
At Christmas time, you should be really cheery, and you should spread good cheer to everybody.
What should you do?
You shouldn't spend all your money.
Don't do drugs.
Be cool.
And stay in school.
Don't mess around with your sister or brothers.
Thank you. Know.
Valentine's Day is about love.
It's eating good chocolate, definitely.
It's being with your loved one and when you can take advantage of the boys because they're supposed to love you, so they're not supposed to hit you unless you take your turn. And I feel that they should give you gifts and roses and expect nothing in return.
This is what Valentine's all about.
Gifts and money and presents.
See this ring? That's what my boyfriend gave me.
And candy and flowers.
Candy and roses and
love.
Being nice and
balloons and, well, dozen red monster roses. You'll get them $1.99 rose from 7-Eleven, and that's it.
Bunch of red roses.
Valentine's Day to me is love and peace and harmony, like every day should be.
Friendship and love. And being in love. That's what it's all about. Vicki, Yama.
Love and happiness.
Love, peace, joy. Ronnie.
Yeah.
Gotta dance.
And being with your girlfriend and stuff. Oh, man.
My
Valentine's
honey.
Day.
Oh, baby.
Hey, Blake.
This is Valentine's to me. Right here.
Valentine's means
when St. Valentine's Day was killed, this day is in his memory.
Spending money on stupid presents on a girl.
Saw her face.
Fondest childhood memory would be my first Christmas off getting my first bike.
Seeing my brother get born. That was a good one.
The first time I went to my first football game, it was cold. It was food cost an arm and a leg.
Fondest childhood memory? I'm still a child.
When I was 4 years old, my mom took me to a carnival for my birthday, and one of those little policemen came to me, and he asked my name was Kelly, and I said, yeah, and he goes, was it your birthday today? And I said, yeah, and he handed me a big pink teddy bear, and to this day, we don't know who it was, and we don't know how I knew it was my birthday, but it was. Isn't that neat?
But I was just a crazy little girl. I had a fun childhood.
When I went to Disneyland in Japan.
Playing in the playground with my friends, probably.
I had a Barbie doll, and I used to comb the hair, and it was really fun. We used to play house and stuff. Okay, that's it.
Going down the hill in the snow with my cousin.
I had a home run, my first Little League game.
My first game of Little League. I had 2 home runs the first 2 times at bat, and then the 3rd time I got hit with the ball.
I first got a bike, and I learned how to ride it.
I won Miss Cowgirl Yolo County.
Going down to the creek with my brothers and sisters, and catching frogs and tadpoles.
When I didn't have to go to school and I could sleep in whenever I wanted, watch cartoons all day, every day. Weekends was like another day to me because the whole week was the same as the weekend. I could really kick back. And now it's gonna be like that again till college starts.
What you doing to me? Yeah, think about what you're trying to do.
Tonight we're gonna go to a couple parties, and then after that we're gonna get serious and start a real life.
Meet somebody.
We're going to college.
Yes. Solano.
But I gotta come to Santa Barbara because I miss Christy so much. So
that's it. So we have to be together and go to Solano.
College. USC.
What are you doing for college?
We're going to USC. We're
going to Sac State.
Trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue.
My graduation from Fairfield.
And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue. Bright, blessed day, a dark, sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. Friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more. When I look anew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
August 2nd, 1990, 100,000 Iraqi troops stormed across the border and brutally captured its tiny neighbor of Kuwait in a matter of hours. President Bush responded by sending 125,000 troops to protect Saudi Arabia in Operation Desert Shield.
Saddam is making the mistake of his life.
The United Nations issued a January 15th deadline for Iraq to withdraw from Kuwait. More than 1 million armed personnel stared each other down, waiting.
liberation of Kuwait has begun.
5 months ago, Saddam Hussein started this cruel war against Kuwait. Tonight, the battle has been joined.
For 5 weeks, the coalition battered Baghdad and Kuwait with air attacks. Iraq was so overwhelmed with the strength of the Allies that its only response was through Soviet-made Scud missiles. American-made Patriot missiles intercepted most of the incoming Scuds. Hussein attempted to dislodge other Arab states from the coalition by attacking Israel. The Jewish nation refused to retaliate against fatal bombings of Tel Aviv, and the coalition remained intact. In a desperate act of environmental blackmail, Hussein ordered the release of millions of barrels of oil into the Persian Gulf and the torching of hundreds of Kuwaiti oil wells. Back home, there was no shortage of opinions on either side of the Gulf War issue.
You want me to go? Why you want me to go to Kuwait?
On February 23rd, the multinational force led by General Norman Schwarzkopf launched the much-anticipated ground offensive against the Iraqis. With Iraqi soldiers surrendering by the thousands, the war lasted little more than 100 hours. Saddam Hussein accepted all UN resolutions calling for his withdrawal from Kuwait and payment of reparations and war damages. As school ended, the war's effects lingered. Millions of Kurdish refugees who sought safety in the mountains waited, both hungry and cold, for a chance to return home.
With all his heart.